There are currently four Chinese vessels patrolling this area on the outskirts of the shoal.
There's trouble in the South China Sea. The Chinese government is amassing ships, taking over reefs and rocks.
This is Philippine Coast Guard. You are requested to provide name of vessel.
We sail into occupied maritime territory to take a closer look at Beijing's aggressive policy and the militia it uses to enforce it.
Come here. They're coming here. Okay, let's go.
5 years since a landmark legal victory for the Philippines, we ask whether China is adhering to the ruling.
What you get is this overwhelming narrative that's now global of China as a bully, China as a rules breaker in the South China Sea.
We head straight into the century's hottest geopolitical dispute and meet Filipino fishermen caught in the middle.
Dapat pag hindi naman inyo, huwag nyo naman pong gawin yung para sa amin.
Bolinao is a fishing community in the northwest of the Philippines. George has been fishing since he was just 12 years old.
Ako po ay mangingisda. Mangingisda po aking hanap buhay. Sa hirap po ng buhay, hindi nakapag-aral. Kaya ito, talagang mangingisda lang talagang alam kong hanap buhay.
George's son JR fishes too, but worries for his future.
Baka pag wala na tayong mahuling isda, baka yung pamilya natin magutom. Ang anak natin, hindi natin mapagtapos ng pag-aaral.
George and JR fish in the hotly contested South China Sea. $3.5 trillion worth of international trade passes through here every year. It's believed to hold sizable reserves of oil and gas. Six countries claim exclusive economic zones according to a United Nations treaty, each one stretching up to 200 nautical miles from their coastlines. The area in the middle is regarded as international waters. But China stands alone in claiming all of the territory and its resources within its disputed nine-dash line created after World War II. George and JR fish at Scarborough Shoal, around 160 nautical miles from Bolinao and more than 400 nautical miles from China's coast. The shoal is above water at high tide, so does have its own territorial sea, but the Philippines claim it as theirs. Vietnam also claims historical rights to fish there. China has been blockading the lagoon since 2012. George and his son JR have been repeatedly chased away from Scarborough Shoal. They've agreed to take me with them to witness what happens at sea.
Sa pangingisda namin ngayon sa South China Sea. Tapos, yeah, mahirap mangisda. Hindi basta-basta mangisda dyan dahil napakadalikado po talaga.
This journey became riskier earlier this year when China changed its Coast Guard law to allow the use of weapons to eliminate dangers when their national sovereignty is being infringed upon. After 22 hours of sailing, we arrive at Scarborough Shoal. It's high tide and the reef is hardly breaking the surface. But if you look closely, waves from the deep blue ocean break on a lighter turquoise body of water. That's the limestone reef you can see in this satellite image. Easier to spot is the Chinese presence.
So there's a Chinese Coast Guard vessel that's watching us at the moment. It's done three sweeps. First of all, 200 meters away, then 100 meters away, and now 50 meters away. It's watching our every move.
Kaya nga eh, sarili nating teritoryo. Bakit sarili nating teritoryo, ninanakaw natin yung isda, sariling isda natin.
The Coast Guard ship leaves without incident, but it's made its point. Going inside Scarborough Shoal is off limits.
Baka sa susunod na taon, baka di na tayo makapunta ng Scarborough Shoal. Kasi ang Scarborough Shoal ay pinahigpitan talaga ng China. Baka sa susunod na taon, pagbabawalan na tayo ng China, talaga makukuha nila to.
Instead, the crew stay on the outside, fanning out in small boats. They're rigged to compressor pumps and long tubes, a risky alternative to air tank diving. They pass by what looks like old torpedo or artillery shells, possible remnants from the time America maintained military bases in the Philippines and used the shoal as a firing range. Day two, and we're going inside the lagoon, carefully evading the attention of the Chinese blockade of the eastern entrance. George and JR take the risk for this. Woo! A giant talakitok, worth roughly $40. That's more than the average national daily wage in the Philippines.
Picture.
The one thing that strikes me about Scarborough Shoal is how fitting the name is. Shoal is Old English for shallow, and everywhere I've looked in the last 20 minutes, it's been maybe chest height max. Given how flat it is, it's an ideal place for land reclamation, and China have a long history in doing exactly that.
Scarborough Shoal isn't the only reef in the South China Sea that China has taken an interest in. Satellite images from 2012 to 2020 of Mischief Reef in the Spratly Islands reveal it slowly being transformed into a muscular military base, complete with airstrips and anti-aircraft guns. At Mischief and six other reefs in the Spratlys, China used dredgers to dump sand and rock on top of coral reefs, turning them into artificial islands. Similar developments have taken place in the Paracels, another group of islands where China maintains a constant presence. Some believe if Beijing builds on Scarborough Shoal, it will completely control access to the South China Sea.
Last and next port of coal, over.
Tensions rose this year when China began swarming reefs and rocks with hundreds of boats in the Spratly Islands.
This is Philippine Coast Guard. You are within Philippine Exclusive Economic Zone. You are requested to provide the following. Name of vessel. Intention. Last and next port of call.
Philippine Secretary of Foreign Affairs Teodoro Loxin Jr. had had enough and tweeted asking China to get the F out of Philippine waters. I spoke with Secretary Loxin to ask why he reacted so strongly.
Talk us through your Twitter feed and your rants and explosive tweets.
I believe, as a matter of conviction, that four-letter words do not add to your argument. But sometimes it just is so frustrating because it happens again and again, and I do it. And to the extent I can, I erase it because it has never advanced an argument.
Secretary Loxin deleted his tweet and apologized to his Chinese counterpart. A spokesperson said they hoped a certain individual from the Philippine side will mind basic manners and act in a way that suits his status. This is Scarborough Shoal at low tide. It's named after a British trading ship that ran aground here in the 18th century. Filipinos refer to it as Panatag, or Peaceful Shoal. You can see hundreds of these rocks jutting out from the waterline. And although it seems like a benign place, this is an area that is at the center of a major geopolitical dispute. On the one hand, China claims large swathes of these waters as theirs. And then you have countries like the United Kingdom, United States, Australia, and India coming together with this Indo-Pacific doctrine, this idea that these waters should be free and accessible to all. America's Indo-Pacific strategy aims to reassert its influence in Asia by working with its allies to promote rules-based international order.
When nations try to game the system or tip the rules in their favor, it throws everything off balance. That's why we are so adamant that these areas of the world remain peaceful, whether that's the South China Sea, the Arabian Gulf, and increasingly the Arctic. It's of vital interest to America's foreign policy to secure unimpeded flow of global commerce.
The United Kingdom plans to test that freedom later this year when its new flagship aircraft carrier, the HMS Queen Elizabeth, will sail through the South China Sea. China sees international moves to keep these seas open as a plot to contain its rise and sabotage its stability. But the country signed the 1982 United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, the international legal framework to settle maritime disputes. When the Philippines used the law to challenge China in the Permanent Court of Arbitration, the tribunal ruled that China had unlawfully prevented Filipinos from fishing in Scarborough Shoal. China didn't participate in the tribunal, nor accept its findings. On our fifth day at Scarborough Shoal, winds marking the beginning of the monsoon season rock George's boat.
It's around 6 o'clock in the morning here, and we've moved to the eastern entrance of Scarborough Shoal. On the horizon, you can't see anything apart from three big boats, and they're guarding the eastern entrance to Scarborough Shoal.
Normally, under these weather conditions, Philippine vessels would shelter inside the lagoon. But this is no longer possible under China's control, a violation of the 2016 ruling.
Napakadelikado po talaga sa labas ka mag-angkla. Hindi ka talaga basta-basta makatulog doon na pag ikaw ang kapitan ng bangka, nasa labas ka nga ng Scarborough. So, pag naputol yung angkla mo, talagang mapapadpad ka sa mababa, masisira yung bangka mo.
JR and I want to take a closer look at the blockaded eastern entrance. After 10 minutes in the mouth of Scarborough Shoal, we notice a boat moving quickly towards us. I don't want to attract their attention, so I hide my camera. JR wants us to get out of here.
Okay, let's go.
The boat that sped at us belongs to China's third force. Not the Navy, not the Coast Guard, but the Maritime Militia. This year, the same paramilitary group released a music video showing a training exercise where a small fishing boat is rammed.
Oh,
ang sa pinakamahirap doon ay yung nangingis, ang ganda ng pangingisda mo, habulin ka ng China, papaalisin kayo sa Scalburo Shoal, pagbabawalin kayo mga isda. Mga na-experience ko na dapat hindi na maulit yung ganun pangyayari na payagan na sana tayong mga isda ng mga Chinese, wala nang gulo.
Over the last 10 years or so, some small component, probably a few hundred boats of this militia force, has been professionalized. The national government and provincial governments have dumped money into upgrading them, building new boats, giving them uniforms and weapons training, and integrating them into the chain of command of the China Coast Guard and the Chinese Navy. So now you've got a militia that really is a professional paramilitary force.
By cross-referencing our footage with satellite data, it appears that the militia vessel that sped at us is called Qiong Sansha Yu 00311.
We can't get a very good handle on what exactly it was doing, other than being there at the shoal for weeks at a time. And this is one of the major problems that you face throughout the South China Sea. You've got at least 300 Chinese militia boats operating in contested areas every day of the year, and the vast majority of them you can't see until you basically bump into one.
In the 2016 ruling, the tribunal found that China's vessels had moved in a dangerous manner, causing a serious risk of collision. The militia that sailed at us came at speed and close to our boat. The Chinese government refers to Scarborough Shoal as Hyongyan Island. We asked the Chinese embassy in the UK to comment on our evidence. They said,
"The Hyongyang Island is China's territory and its adjacent waters are under China's jurisdiction. The tribunal's award in the South China Sea arbitration is illegal, null and void. China neither accepts nor recognises the award, and we firmly oppose any claims or actions based on it. China's sovereignty, rights and interests in the South China Sea have been formed through a long course of history and are consistent with international law."
Filipinos are fighting for control of what they define as the West Philippine Sea. Under President Rodrigo Duterte, relations with America have deteriorated, calling into question the two countries' military alliance.
His foreign minister may have told Beijing to F off, but in the past, President Duterte has made no bones about steering the country towards closer ties with China.
"I announced my separation from the United States. I have separated from them. So I will be dependent on you for all time."
President Duterte recently said he doesn't respect the 2016 arbitration ruling that handed his country a legal victory over China.
"Sabihin ko sa'yo, bigay mo sa akin, sabihin ko, putang ina, papel lang yan. Itatapong ko yan sa waste basket."
"Pag sinabi kong Duterte, ang sagot ninyo, resign!"
Representative Nery Colmenares is a member of the left-wing Philippine opposition coalition, Bayan Muna.
"The moment the president of the Philippines says that he will throw it to the trash can, that can be used by China to justify its encroachment of the entire South China Sea. So for us, it is really treacherous on the part of the president to disavow or at least set aside a decision that is really a major victory, not just for the Philippines, but for other countries that are being trampled upon by China in the South China Sea."
President Duterte's Secretary for Foreign Affairs denies that Chinese financial aid influences Philippine policy.
"They say, why are so much deals in China? When you look at it, we have struck more financing deals with Japan. So if you look at the figures, our partner is Japan. Everything that needs to be done to protect our sovereignty, our rights, has been to preserve what's ours."
It's our final day at sea. last year, Filipino fishermen from Zambales province, the closest to Scarborough Shoal, have lost an estimated 70% of their income because of the blockade of the lagoon, according to a National Federation of Fishermen. Masinloc is a fishing town in Zambales. Mario and his wife Luz used to earn a living fishing, but stopped when they were harassed by the Chinese authorities at Scarborough Shoal. Now they work here at the market.
Siyempre, masama ang loob dahil nawalan kami ng magandang pagkakitaan. Kasi sa Scarborough talagang sandali lang, sa loob ng tatlong buwan, malaki na ang kinikita.
Siyempre masakit at para ano, sana tuloy-tuloy sana yon. Kaso mo, wala.
Tiyatsaga na lang sa palengke. Tiyatsaga
na lang sa palengke. Mas talaga mas maganda talaga sa Scarborough, mangisda sa Scarborough.
What's your message to those fishermen who say they're out of pocket now because of the incursion in Scarborough Shoal? What would be your message to them?
Oh, you mean the fishermen who've lost? Well, I think we should take care of them. We owe it to them. So support them.
Mario and Luz aren't just worried about financial support, but also the prospect of conflict between superpower nations playing out on their doorstep.
Pag nagkaroon ng gera, siyempre natatakot kami dahil kami mga ordinaryong tao. Wala kami kakayanan na i-depensa ang sarili namin sa gera.
Siyempre matatakot ka rin ako magigira na. Dapat hindi mangyari yun.
The reasons behind China's combative actions in the South China Sea are unclear. Whether the motive is natural resources, fish, oil and gas, or to protect themselves from invasion, calm diplomatic heads will be needed to prevent escalation and a conflict that is in nobody's interest.